Welcome to another episode of Bite Size. My name is June, and I'm here today with my very special guest, Blanca Delgado. Welcome.
Thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Awesome. Why don't you take a minute to introduce yourself?
Absolutely. Hi, everyone. I'm a program manager at Microsoft, and I have the pleasure to work in the awesome team of Visual Studio Mobile Center. I am currently responsible for two services in Mobile Center, which are analytics and push notifications.
So today, we are going to be talking about the analytics service within Mobile Center. What are we learning about today?
So today, we will learn how to integrate the SDK in order to have analytics ready in Mobile Center. We will also walk you through how to integrate custom events in your code in order to get more insights into your data.
Very cool. So without further ado, let's get into the demo now.
All right, we are now in Mobile Center and we signed into mobile.azure.com. Blanca, what's next?
For this demo, we've already created one app. It's called Demo App. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on it and we will jump directly into analytics. We can see that we have three tabs called Audience, Events, and Logflow. We can see that we don't have any data yet. So in order to see some data, we have to integrate the SDK. So in order to do so, I've created a Xamarin Android app in Xamarin Studio. I'm gonna go ahead and show the app. This app will tell us what is the tip that we need to have for a specific bill. Let's say our bill is $100 and I wanna tip 20%. The tip will be $20 and the total amount will be $120. Now we are gonna go back to our Mobile Center portal to see how to integrate the SDK. So right now I'm gonna go to the Getting Started page in order to look into the instructions. Because this is a Xamarin Android app, we have here different steps that we need to follow. The first thing we need to do is add the NuGet packages to our project. We will look for Mobile Center, Mobile Center Analytics, and in case we wanted to add crashes, we would also look for Mobile Center crashes. In this case, I am not gonna do it. So I'm gonna go back to the app. Right now we are back in Xamarin Studio. I'm gonna go ahead and press into packages. I will look for the first one, Mobile Center. And there it is. I'm gonna go ahead and click. I'm also gonna look into Mobile Center Analytics. Here it is, I will press on it, and now I can say add both packages. All right, it says here, we are adding the packages, and there you go, done. What is the next step? We are now ready to start the SDK. In order to do so, I will go into my mainactivity.cs file, and I will add the following statements. As I mentioned above, I am not gonna include crashes, so I will only use the first two lines. I go back to Xamarin Studio, and include these two. All right, done. What is the next step? The next step we need to do is go to the onCreate method in the mainActivity.cs and copy this line of code. This will basically start the SDK. This number right here is what we call the app secret. This will be app dependent. So if you create a different app, it will have a different app secret. So please make sure that we have the right app secret. So I will go ahead and copy that, go back to Xamarin Studio and copy that into the onCreate method. So as I said before, I am not including crashes for this demo, so I will go ahead and remove that from here. And once that it's done, that's all. And that is all we need to do in order to integrate analytics into our code.
Awesome, Blanca. So it seems like we just need two main steps. First, we need to copy the specific analytics library that we're going to be using. And then second, we need to copy in the analytics portion of this little snippet of code to make the analytics portion work, correct?
Absolutely, that's all you need to do. So now we have integrated the SDK and we are gonna land our first user, which is gonna be us using the simulator. I'm gonna go ahead, run the app. So we are the first user that our analytics is going to track. So here is our app. That means we have our first active user. Right now, I'm gonna go ahead and go back to the analytics portal. As you would expect, it's gonna take some time to populate the data, usually a few minutes. So here it goes. The audience page is loaded. Now, let's look into these charts. The first charts show us how many users we have in our app. The first chart we see is the active users. As you can see, we have only one user, which is us, because we just ran the app for the first time. We also have information about sessions. How many sessions per user do we have? How much time do my users spend in the app? If my app is a game, I'm expecting my users to be in my app for longer time than another type of app. We also get information about the top devices that my users are using. Are they using Samsung? Are they using Nexus? You also get insights about countries and languages. Where are my users located? What language do they speak? Last but not least, we get information about the active devices per version. This will allow you to understand if your users are adopting your latest release or not. Also note that we have filtering by app version and time range. This will allow you to specify your charts for a specific version or for a specific time range. Let's say you want to focus on the last week because you had a release.
Wow, this is super cool. So just from a bird's eye view, I could quickly see from daily sessions per users coupled with the session's duration and along the top devices. So now if I want to see more specific data in terms of my elements on my page, is that what the events function is for here?
Yes. Events will allow you to understand the interaction of your users with your app. So let's go ahead and track one of these custom events. I'm going to go to the Mobile Center documentation by pressing into the question mark. So let's go to the SDK section under Analytics, and in our case, Xamarin. So as you can see here, tracking an event is fairly simple. We can track events per se, or we can attach properties to it. For demo purposes, let's track an event. So I'm going to go ahead, copy the line of code necessary to track an event, and let's go back to Xamarin Studio. Now, what do I want to track? Let's say I want to track how many people hit on the calculate button. Go to the method for the calculate button and paste that line of code. I'm going to change the name of the event to calculate was pressed. So let's run the app again in order to track this event. So the idea is that when I press into the calculate button, an event will be triggered, and hopefully we'll see it in the Mobile Center portal. So let's run the app again. All right, let's hit an example. Let's say my bill was $28 and I want to tip 10%. Once I hit calculate, I will be triggering one event. Let's do it. All right, done. Now I'm going to go ahead, go back to the Mobile Center portal and go into events. I want to note here that events might take a little bit longer to load. So in the meantime, let's check out Logflow. What is Logflow? Well, Logflow allows you to see real-time incoming activity. So in this case, we see the three sessions that we ran, as well as the event. Now I just have to wait a few minutes and wait for the events to load.
That's really cool. So you get to see a very detailed systematic report of exactly what is going on within your app from the start session to different events. And I believe if you hook up crashes to it, you could see crashes on here too as well, right?
Exactly. You would also see crashes happening in real time. So here is our event, Calculate Was Pressed. And what insights do we get here? So we see count, users. So what are these? So count means how many times an event was triggered. We also have information about count per user and count per session.
This is so great as a developer because I could precisely see all the actions that are taking place within my application. You know, how many times people are hitting on different events that I put tags on. And that in conjunction with the audience tab, where we go back over here, this will definitely guide me on what features I should build out, what features I should deprecate due to no one really using it. Maybe certain features to improve on because I understand that that is a very highly used element within my application.
Also, I would like to add that we can attach properties to events. So if we go back to the documentation, we see an example here. Let's say you have an application where you have a send document. This send document button is really highly used, but you would like to understand what type of format am I user using when they send the document. Are they using PNG? Are they using PDF? Properties will allow you to understand things like that. The distribution, which one is more popular?
Thank you so much, Blanca. So between custom events and audience and the log flow, it will greatly, greatly help any developer out there to iterate on their current application and how to make the application better.
Blanca, thank you so much for joining us today. I hope everyone learned as much as I did.
My pleasure. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much for watching. And as always, I appreciate you.
Peace.
Peace.